I used to own the domain fredarmisenfans.com. I was going to make a whole website about Fred Armisen. My path was really weird. I loved performing when I was little. I wanted to be a singer at first, but I was told that I didn't have a very good voice at a very young age, so I lost all my confidence in singing. Then I found acting and being on stage, and I thought that was great, but my parents were like, how are you gonna make money doing that? And I was like, good point, Dad. I ended up getting a degree in economics, supply equals demand. That's all I learned. What does that even mean? I don't know. But then I got a graduate degree in design, which was like more creative and a little bit more towards what I wanted to do, but I still missed acting. Around age 30, I was like, you know what, I owe it to myself to really try acting again. And so I started auditioning and getting rejected and auditioning and rejected. Then I tried stand-up comedy and I loved writing my own lines. I loved being myself a lot more than being a character. And that's when I went broke, because when you're a stand-up comedian, you don't really get paid to do stand-up comedy. You have to pay people to like let you get on their stage. Then I ended up at Google, and I was at Google for a while, and I was doing stand-up at night, and I was writing, and I was still trying to do comedy. I was doing comedy in meetings. Everybody wanted to be in a meeting with me because I didn't take any of it seriously, because I was like, no, this is just for money. I really want to do entertainment. Finally, I combined the two things. I combined my corporate life with my love of comedy, and I wrote 10 Tricks to Appear Smart in Meetings. That was this viral blog that got seen by millions of people. It turned into a book. I ended up leaving Google. I was working on that book, and I was still doing stand-up, and I started speaking at conferences, and then I wrote How to Be Successful Without Hurting Men's Feelings, which was another book based on my life in the corporate world. Those books did fine. I really wanted them to become something bigger. I wasn't really getting any calls back from agents or from TV people. I wrote a pilot, you know, people read it, but then never wrote me back. And so I kind of given up. Then the pandemic happened. I was forced to try something new. And that thing that I tried was lip syncing President Trump on TikTok. It really took off. People really enjoyed seeing his voice coming out of my mouth for some reason. I don't shy away from trying weird things. All of a sudden, there was new attention on my books. I got signed with an agent. My agent was like, you know, you should put together a special. And I pitched it to Natasha Lyonne and Maya Rudolph, and they were like, yeah, let's do it. And I was like, I just met you. Like, you're my heroes, I just met you, and now you wanna work with me? Even just meeting them was this moment of like, how am I on a Zoom call with Maya Rudolph and Natasha Lyonne? Sometimes we were able to actually meet in person with masks and being socially distanced. When I met Maya, I was like, I wanna hug you, but I can't. Fred Armisen, when I was texting with Natasha, she was like, you know, Fred's here, Fred thinks everything's great, you know? And I was like, oh my God, Fred Armisen is reading things that I wrote? I used to own the domain fredarmisenfans.com. I was gonna make a whole website about Fred Armisen. I never actually did it, but I did own the website for a little while. It's been a really interesting process of just trying things and giving up and trying another thing and giving up again and trying another thing and then finally something working to the point where so many people have seen it and love it and support it. And now I have so many opportunities that I've been looking for like pretty much my whole life. You always think that you're too old, and the thing is, you're never too old. If you still have a passion for something, you should still be doing it. Getting through imposter syndrome is impossible. It's really hard. It's something that never goes away, and you never feel like, okay, I'm done. Imposter syndrome, gone. Yeah, I feel like I totally belong here. I deserve everything I have. I'm not a fraud. Like, those feelings of feeling like you don't deserve what you have, they'll never really go away. I think it's more about ignoring them. I think as women, we constantly question everything we do as not good enough. And so many ideas that we all have just sit in a notebook. Get that notebook out, because those ideas are probably like way better than you realize. Stop overjudging everything. Put everything out there. Like, give yourself a chance. Don't sleep on yourself. And that's how I got started. I hope you enjoy it, and I hope you'll watch Sarah Cooper Everything's Fine. It's now streaming on Netflix.